Shaping sounds with an envelope has been a common feature of audio production since the early days of hardware synthesizers. In Renoise and Redux, the sampler's modulation section gives you a huge amount of control for crafting envelopes by combining the available devices. However, two of those devices, the AHDSR, which is covered in another video, and the subject of this video, the envelope, are both capable of creating multi-stage envelopes entirely on their own. The main graphical section of this device displays the envelope and the points used to create it. Left-clicking on a point will select it, and click-dragging will move it around. Holding down left control will display the current value of a point and also lock it in place horizontally, allowing you to fine-tune its value vertically. Double-clicking in the envelope will create a new point, while double-clicking on an existing point will remove it. For even more editing options in a larger workspace, hit this button to open the external editor. The parameter underneath at the right here sets the length of the envelope. There's also the usual interpolation modes, and a bank of presets for storing and recalling envelopes. The most common place to use an AHDSR is in a sample's volume domain, where it's a ready-made tool for approximating how a real instrument behaves over time. And unlike the points of an envelope, any of the AHDSR's parameters can be mapped to macros. Aside from this though, the envelope device has many advantages. The most obvious one is that while the AHDSR is restricted to 5 phases, you can build as many as you'd like with the envelope. And the initial attack phase doesn't have to start from zero. A sustain point is optional here, and when enabled, allows the user to create their own custom release phase. When an envelope device is used in the volume domain, then it also has an additional release parameter for an optional fade out. Note that it uses a legacy system of 0 to 4096, where higher values cause quicker fade outs. This release stage can be incredibly useful when used alongside the loop feature. The start and end points can be placed anywhere on the envelope, and so now playback will cycle through this section according to the selected loop type. This takes the place of the sustain point if it's not active. But if it is, then playback stops there and then moves into the loop upon a note-off event. If note-offs are unfamiliar to you, then check out our previous video on the subject for full details. What you need to know here though is that a note off will cause any AHDSR or envelope devices in this instrument to immediately advance to their release phase. If you're new to creating modulations and you're wondering why these devices are still just cutting to silence, remember that by default, waveform playback will simply stop. You need to override this with the release phase of an AHDSR or envelope device in the volume domain. And or extending a sample loop by enabling this button in the waveform section. And finally, if you'd like to assume direct control while a song's playing, the Exx Effect Command can be used to jump an instrument's envelopes to a playback position defined by the Exx value. This functions exactly as you would expect, with the values from 00 through to FF acting as a timeline that reaches across the length of the whole envelope. Yeah.